George.
Well, come on up here.
What are we doing? What you got?
We're going to get into some period clothing. This is a Union Army
George.
Frock coat.
George, my name is Lee. Shouldn't I be in a Confederate?
Well, Union Army's okay. And then you want to fasten that all the way up because they always kept the top button buttoned.
So you just look like a gentleman.
Well, of course. I always dress as a gentleman because I am a gentleman.
Yes. Okay, the gentleman and the Union. Am I an officer?
You're a private.
Private.
Really? That's good.
We're at the Rosenberg Library. This is museum curator Eleanor Barton. Eleanor, you remember when you took me up to the attic and you pointed out some cannonballs?
I sure do.
These are all cannonballs that were salvaged after the Battle of Galveston that took place here on January 1st, 1863. Some of these have even been mounted in kind of a decorative way to serve as a souvenir. And we've also got weapons, firearms, naval swords here in the collection. Most of these belong to people who lived here in Galveston.
I showed that clip to my buddy George and asked him to tell me about it. Let's watch. Why are we on this street and what's it have to do with those cannonballs?
Well, during the Battle of Galveston. So let's kind of put this in the time frame. This is January 1st, 1863. The artillery battery here opens fire. They're starting to shoot at the ships at Coon's Wharf. The United States Navy returns fire. Now these are several big warships with big cannons. They are firing those cannonballs through town here. Some of them will hit the Henley Building right behind us here. Others will fly down through this street. It'll hit the existing buildings. It'll hit St. Mary's Church. It'll hit the old federal courthouse. Some of the soldiers, these cannonballs are flying down the street. You can see them. These are not supersonic. You can see it going through the air, and it will come bouncing and rolling down that street.
So there's some cannonballs. Those cannonballs hit this building.
Cannonballs are hitting this building. Okay, so if you look right up here, this is one of the few tangible pieces that we have from the American Civil War, the Battle of Galveston. This is cannon damage right here. Cannonball knocks this corner off. Now again, like we were talking, there's a lot of other buildings that are hit here during the war, during that battle. But this is one of the few buildings that is left from that time period.
As it turns out, the Rosenberg Library has an entire exhibit about the Battle of Galveston. Eleanor, can you show me some of these cannonballs?
Yeah, so we've got a couple of different examples of cannonball types here. The two that you see here that are painted gold, this one's got Battle of Galveston written on it, and then the one in the back has both Texas and Confederate flags painted on it. These are examples of solid shot cannonballs, and so they are just a pure solid ball of iron, and those would, when they were shot out, they would really do some damage to buildings and also to ships if they were being shot at by ships. These were collected after the battle and then painted and mounted as souvenirs, and that was something that was fairly common after the battle. Another example of a type that we have here are these much larger mortar balls. And if you look inside, you can see that they're actually about 2 to 3 inches thick on the outside, and then they're completely hollow inside. And this type would have had gunpowder poured inside. It would be plugged with a fuse, and once it was shot out of the cannon and hit its target, it would explode into different pieces.
And I would expect that shrapnel to go everywhere and be fairly lethal.
Exactly. So it would produce shrapnel. And an example of that you can see here. This is another souvenir from the war. And this is a fragment of a cannonball that was shot from a Union vessel that was out in Galveston Bay towards the Henley Building. And it actually became lodged into a baseboard from the Henley Building. Somebody cut that section of the baseboard out and then created this framed souvenir piece. And you can see that they've noted that it's from the Battle of Galveston and where it's from, the Henley Building. So that's a neat piece of Galveston history too.
That Henley Building, it was like ground zero for the Battle of Galveston, wasn't it?
Yes, it definitely was. So we had Confederate soldiers who were shooting cannons and also gunfire from the second story out into the bay, and then you had the Union vessels on their ships shooting towards the Henley Building. So it was definitely ground zero during the Battle of Galveston.